Asian markets ended Thursday trade on a mixed note. This is on holiday thin trade with markets in South Korea and Indonesia closed. The Hong Kong Hang Seng still among the biggest decliners after it announced a trading suspension on China Evergrande. That's following a report its chairman Hui Ka-yan has been placed under police watch, raising more worries about the cash-strapped developer's future amid growing risks of liquidation. Now here at home, Philippine shares managed some gains with the main index inching closer to the 6,400 level.
Ever since that September 20 low, no, around 6,000, they're actually up around 6.85%. And a lot of stocks have shown strong bounces, so that could actually possibly mark their lows already. We have also seen volumes improving by the day, although keep in mind, these volumes could have been largely influenced by the recent index rebalancing activity. So that would be both in the PSEI and the MSCI indices. Can we keep this up? Well, if you look at how the market closed today, if you look at the charts, it is somewhere we somehow anticipated it to find some resistance, because the 6380 to 6400 was the area of support of the, I think, around the 5-month consolidation from around March to until August this year. And if the closing price action is any indication, we can possibly see it at least a halt in this bullish stance.
The Philippine Stock Exchange announces another change in its 30-stock benchmark index. Starting October 4, Union Bank of the Philippines will be removed from the PSEI. The PSE says a number of shares reported by UBP as public was determined to be non-public, bringing its free float below the 20% threshold required. Taking its place in the PSEI will be Nickel Asia Corporation. Just last week, the stock exchange removed Metro Pacific Investments, which is set to go private, and Aboitiz Power Corporation, which also fell below the minimum public float after share buybacks.
Other corporate news, eWallet GCash partners with the Securities and Exchange Commission to help authorities in its scam investigations. That partnership will allow the SEC to identify scam perpetrators and recover victims' lost money. Meanwhile, Fernando Zubeldi Ayala returns to the board of directors of the Ayala Corporation. He will be replacing Mercedita Noliedo. Ayala has also returned as chair of BPI and AC Health. As for East West Bank, it welcomes PhilInvest President and CEO Rhoda Huang as a board member. Before joining PhilInvest, Huang served as president of BPI Capital and head of investment banking at Credit Suisse Philippines. And finally, PhilInvest Land dissolves two non-operating subsidiaries to streamline its corporate structure. Leisure Pro and PhilInvest Life Malls Mimosa have filed their applications with the Securities and Exchange Commission.
The Philippine Tourism Department wants to position the country as an LGBTQ plus friendly destination. That's according to Tourism Chief Christina Frasco, who led the agency's first Tourism Pride Summit in Makati City. The event aimed to explore how the country can develop an inclusive market for LGBTQ plus tourism. Citing 2018 data from a United Nations organization, Frasco said 36 million of travelers globally belong to the LGBTQ plus community.
It is a $200 billion industry that's only slated to grow to a $500 billion industry by 2030. Unang-una po, nais po natin na maging inclusive sa ating turismo. Kaya naman po, binibigyan natin ng honor and recognition yung ating mga members ng LGBTQIA+ community.